Hi students, welcome to the session on plane wave propagation in good conductor. So what is good conductor? A good conductor is one where conductivity tends to infinity, epsilon is equal to epsilon naught, mu is equal to mu naught mu r, and sigma by omega epsilon is far greater than 1. So this is the characters of good conductor, and this equation we have derived for lossy dielectric, plane wave propagation in lossy dielectric. If you didn't see that video, please refer that video, then only you will understand the derivation. Plane wave propagation in lossy dielectric. So now this alpha attenuation, beta phase constant, eta wave impedance, you see intrinsic impedance. So you can substitute this value here and find these characteristics for plane wave propagation in conductor. So first we find alpha value. So what is alpha from the this one? Right, so alpha is given by, you see, alpha is equal to this equation where you can substitute sigma tends to infinity, or sigma by omega epsilon is far greater than 1. That means very high value, right? So if sigma by omega epsilon is far greater than 1, means sigma by omega epsilon square will be far greater than 1. So this one is negligible, so this one is also negligible, so it is root of sigma by omega square, that will be, it will become omega into mu epsilon by 2. This one is negligible, this one is also negligible, because sigma by omega epsilon is far greater than value, greater than 1. So it will be root of sigma by omega epsilon whole square, that will become sigma by omega epsilon, right? So what is the thing happening? So this epsilon and this epsilon will be cancelled. So you see, this omega you bring inside, it will become omega square, right? So omega square mu sigma by 2 omega. So omega cancel, it will be omega mu sigma by 2 root of, right? So alpha is equal to omega mu sigma by 2. The same logic is applicable for beta. 1 cancel. This one is negligible. This one is negligible. So you bring the same thing. So you will get the same parameter. So alpha and beta are same for wave propagation in conductor. So omega, you substitute 2 pi f. So pi f 2 cancel. Pi f mu sigma by pi f mu sigma, right? That's what your attenuation, that's what your phase constant also. I substituted omega is equal to 2 pi f. You see, from this what you are understanding, see, when frequency increases, what happens to attenuation? The attenuation is also increases. When? While wave propagating through good conductor, right? So that is very important. So that's why we should not go for high frequency signal when you transmit the waveform in the good conductor, right? Because when frequency increases, the attenuation will get increased, right? That's what alpha and beta. What about eta? The eta is intrinsic impedance. You see, what is the thing? Eta is j omega mu. Okay, I will derive this. Eta is given by root of j omega mu divided by j omega epsilon plus sigma. Fine. So we know that sigma is far very it is approaching infinity, so this is negligible. So neglect this. So eta will be j omega mu by sigma. Fine. So what is eta value? Eta I can write as root j into mu omega mu by sigma. Root j I can write as e power j pi by 2. Fine. So e power j pi by 2 is nothing but cos pi by 2 plus j sin pi by 2. Cos pi by 2 0, j sin pi by 2 1, so j. So that I can write as e power j pi by 4. Because e power j pi by 2, this is nothing but e power j pi by 2. root is 1 by 2, so that will be e power j pi by 4. Now eta is equal to e power j pi by 4 into omega mu by sigma. That I can write as, in terms of magnitude, if I find magnitude value, what is the magnitude of e power j pi by 4? Magnitude of e power j pi by 4 is 1 pi by 4. The magnitude of root of mu sigma is root of omega mu divided by sigma. That's what my eta. For wave propagation, this is the impedance encountered by a plane wave when it is traveling through a good conductor. Now, what we are understanding from this? We know eta is equal to E by H. So, this indicates electric field is electric field leads magnetic field by 45 degrees. Because E by H is equal to this one, that means E leads H by 45 degrees. So, what is my E equation for this? E is equal to, we know general equation is e power minus alpha z cos omega t minus beta z ax. If you have any doubt, please refer my video on wave propagation in lossy dielectric. So, similarly, H is equal to H naught by eta. Fine, E naught is equal to H naught by eta. E naught by eta. So eta value I found here. What is eta value? Root of omega mu sigma, right? Okay, into e power minus alpha z cos omega t minus beta z. Minus theta will come. Minus theta is 45 degree, right? That is Ay. So, if you have any doubt how this equation has come, please refer my video on plane wave propagation in lossy dielectric. Right? There I found E value and H value. In that E value and H value, I substituted eta value. I got this equation. So, here you see why this indicates E leads H by 45 degree. Fine. So, when plane wave propagates through a conducting medium, E leads H by 45 degree. That is very important. And next thing is, if F increases, attenuation also increases. And next thing you see, when wave propagates through a conductor, the magnitude gets attenuated. Because alpha is attenuation, so always the magnitude gets attenuated. This is the third point. So during propagation in good conductor, the wave gets attenuated. Right? So, these are all very, very important point. So, these things in this one, this is point two, point three. Fine? So, I hope you understand the concept clearly. If you have any doubt, please ask me in comment section. I will clarify all your doubts. Thank you.